This is the fourth video in the series of videos on theorems and proofs about determinants, and I promise it's the last video. And this is also a very important result about determinants. It says that if A and B are n by n matrices, then the determinant of AB is the determinant of A times the determinant of B. This is a very useful result. It says that the determinant of a product is the product of the determinants. And there is nothing in here about A and B needing to be invertible or anything. This is just always going to be true. Now, getting ready to do this proof, I'm going to make a couple of assumptions. I'm going to assume that you have the information from the previous videos, specifically video number 2 about how row operations affect determinants. And also, I'm going to assume that you have done the work in the preliminary exercises that I provided, specifically about question number 2, the question that asks you to show that if AB is invertible, then so is A. And what I'm actually going to use here is the contrapositive of that result, which would say that if A is not invertible, then AB is also not invertible. So the direction that is shown here on this sheet is easier to prove, but we are going to be using the contrapositive of that. So now I come back and I want to prove this. The determinant of a product is the product of the determinant. And so my proof is going to be in two cases. What I'm going to do is assume in one case that A is not invertible, and then in the second case, assume that A is invertible. So case one is that if A is not invertible, and by what we just looked at on that determinant proofs preparation problem, if A is not invertible, then neither is AB. And by the previous video, that means that the determinant of A is equal to 0. So that means that if I look at the result, the determinant of AB has got to be equal to 0 since AB is not invertible, and the determinant of A is not equal to 0, so the determinant of A times the determinant of B must be equal to 0. So what I get here is, in this case, both sides are equal to 0, and therefore they are equal to each other. Case 2 is going to take a little bit more work. So if A is invertible, then what we saw back in video number 2 is that A can be written as a product of elementary matrices. That is, that A is going to be some product of a whole bunch of row operations that were done on the identity matrix. I've labeled them with, you know, E1 going up to EP, and I labeled them in that order, and it doesn't really matter how I labeled them. We just need to know that A is a product of elementary matrices. And then I start with the concept of the determinant of AB, and I want to show you that it is equal to the determinant of A times the determinant of B. So I will make the substitution that A is the product of all of the elementary matrices. So I have just replaced A with all of these elementary matrices. And then in the second video, we showed that if you had just an elementary matrix multiplied by some other matrix, then we could separate the determinant. So that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to take out that first elementary matrix. And that's what I've got here. That theorem that we did in the second video said that you could take out one elementary matrix. Well, if I can take out this elementary matrix, then that means that I could take out this elementary matrix. And I could take out the next one, and I could take out the next one until I had taken out all of those elementary matrices multiplied by that matrix B. And then the reverse of what that theorem said was that if you could take one elementary matrix out, then that means that you could also put an elementary matrix back in. So I could place all of these elementary matrices back together and end up with what we knew to be the matrix A. And what that gives me is that the determinant of AB is equal to the determinant of A times the determinant of B. Ta-da!